for Arizona State. And Doug Martin, the senior tailback, 2 yards deep in the end zone. Breaking free, and Doug Martin across midfield in a foot race. Escapes and puts the Broncos on top instantly. Morris says, I like it. Don't even have to take the field if we get the lead.
Great blocks. I mean, this is what the way Boise State wanted to set the tone. He also shows the physicality and being able to run out of that arm tackle. And then again, another broken tackle. And then the speed at the end to take it all the way to the house.
To Marshall Osweiler, looking downfield, throws into traffic, and it's broken up. Play action, Osweiler rolls and flips it off in the flat. Almost dropped. It is collected and taking a huge hit as Trevor Cole, the tight end, after about a 7-yard gain.
That was a big Boise State, as they are not just a bunch of guys out there scrapping around. They will lay the lumber. That's a true freshman, Lee Hightower, who's a corner who came in there.
Give it away six. They need four on third down. Osweiler pressured, but flips it out behind Marshall, who makes a terrific catch, but then loses his yardage as George Iloka popped him.
Okay, they had to move him to the corner late in the year because of some injuries, and this time he steps up big on third down.
And second down, they flip it inside. Catch made, and blockers in front. Boldevine, the speedster from the Netherlands, into Arizona State territory.
How about the right guard, Chuck Hayes, leading the way downfield? I mean, this is an outstanding effort. 55, right in the middle of your screen. In fact, he's got a few linemen that are trying to keep up with him, but it's only Hayes. Look at the lineman. He's downfield trying to pick up a block 40 yards downfield. I love that.
Empty backfield and Moore. Yeah, drop back and just kind of pooches it. And even does a pretty good job with that as he pulls out the 10-yard line.
He does it all. These coaches are so happy.
They rush only four and third and seven. Osweiler gets it out. Almost picked off and then almost caught by Flugrad.
Facing Moore.
Moore flips to the end zone and has a man wide open. And it's Shoemaker. As the Sun Devils defense was confused by that five receiver formation, easy pickings. Yeah. But old Alden Darby didn't get the message because he let him run right past him. He thought he had some safety help, but then they're flushed. Fires over the middle. Flugrad had his hand on it. Once again, it's Hightower defending. In the pistol formation, Martin gets the handoff. Again, has a big hole. The tough running of Doug Martin inside the 10.
Nightmare. Nobody touches him, but he's going to go through those arm tackles. You better square up on him if you have any chance of...
Chance to further deflate Arizona State. This is Martin. Still on his feet. Inside the five.
5'9", he's 208 pounds. I just love these little backs that have that low center of gravity. Look at his legs.
Perfect. Went for the ankles. Hurting goal. Moore. Into the end zone. Caught. Touchdown. Back shoulder by the freshman, Matt Miller. Catches. Caught a Hail Mary against Wyoming. This one pretty easy. Receiver's hands tonight, by the way. This is Marshall just trying to get something going, but you really can't run wide very well on Boise State. Nobody has all year.
No. How you feeling right now? Because the team in blue is not gonna let up. If anything, they're gonna push even harder.
They got a mean streak, don't they? This defensive line loves to punish and pile
Absolutely.
On.
That's what they love playing with each other,
yep.
too.
Osweiler on play action, takes a shot over the middle, had a man open, but it's almost intercepted by big old Byron Hout.
Much about this defensive line. It's you said it, seniors across the board. Here, this.
Let's go, last one right here, sir.
Yes, Jarrell Root's kind of the character. Crawford, the Canadian there, went in the middle. He's a Vegas native. McClellan, the silent guy, he said he's made about two speeches in his entire career. Long for Osweiler over the middle. It's caught, but short of the first down is Robinson.
Yeah, chance to talk to, and you know, they said, you know, a lot of people talk about Boise State being scrappy and overachieving. They said, you know, there's eight or nine, maybe 10 guys are going to be in NFL camps next year. Probably three or four of them off the defensive line.
They're going to go for it here, Kirk, on fourth and one. Desperation time. Up. Second thoughts as they bring on the punt team.
They better think about that one.
Kirk, there's no such thing as it win one for the Gipper anymore. That just is rarely happens in college football. Ross comes in motion. You look far side, fade, and it's way overthrown. Robinson was well covered. No chance for a play there, and it's fourth down.
The safety, George Aloka, gets matched up. See the difference in size there?
He's a strong guy.
Aloka's 6'3", yeah. 213 pounds.
Backfield, still three receivers bunched to the right, but he flips it across the left to Ifa, the tight end. And that ball distribution, do you think he knew before the snap where he was going that time?
Well, he always does. I mean, he just sits back there so comfortably.
Here's the reverse. And the pass coming, it's other Moore showing why he's not the quarterback in the family.
And his target is far away.
Here's the right Moore, the lefty delivers, and that's what Little Brothers does. He does better, he catches the ball. Kellen hands it off to Martin. Martin, again, waits for his blockers, breaks from the clear.
But the way he's able to recognize and then accelerate upfield to go along with his power, he just makes him a handful. He studies Drew Brees a lot, being undersized, just a little movement in the pocket. Buys himself a little bit of time, and then the accuracy after the movement.
Now they've got more out of there. And here's the backup quarterback under center on first and goal. They flip it out. It's a trick play and an easy touchdown. That's how it's supposed to happen as Miller finds Ifa. Not fair.
It's just not fair.
American Airlines and zero running game. In fact, less than zero for the Sun Devils on the ground.
And you have got to be able to run the football at least a little bit against this Boise State front. Third and six or third and eight, and they're getting a little bit of pressure on it.
This time they just try the onside kick, and Boise State not fooled. It'll be Sweater at the Broncos 45 on play action. He's pressured and dropped. Billy Wynn, a Las Vegas native, with a play. To Willie, incomplete. Well covered there by Jamar Taylor, and on third down, 0-for-7. And look at Osweiler. He's
taking
wild.
Over.
He is just taking.
Yeah, he just told the coaches, forget about it.
He sure did.
You guys aren't going to be here next year. I am. I'm going for this on fourth down.
That is as forceful as a quarterback can get, with both hands pushing the punt team off the field. He's got a third down. Can they get a fourth down? Here comes the pressure. Osweiler chucks it downfield, and it's underthrown. They against all out. There's the ladder in motion. AJ Manning first down as Osweiler rolls out, puts it in the flat. That's Cole, who's fighting forward, but will be stopped a couple yards short of the goal line. And second and goal. Marshall hammering straight ahead, stopped short.
By Marshall and Howe.
He's a big back. He's tough to stop.
He's 225 pounds, and we're in bowl season, so maybe up to 230.
Marshall hitting the backfield and dropped for a loss. Chase Baker combining with Crawford as they beat the blockers, and now it's fourth down.
Evening actually just comes around. It's a little move there. Exactly what Teller was thinking there. On
fourth and goal, but this time a yard and a half, and Dennis wants a timeout.
They don't get it, though. Snap the ball.
And the end zone intercepted. Picked off by Taylor. He's going to try to go end zone to end zone as Osweiler gives chase. Momentum back to the Broncos. Erickson could see that coming.
That, my friends, is Arizona State season in a nutshell right there.
Did it. Quick conversation with Mazzoni, signaling timeout. You can see the frustration. Erickson looking. Did he get the official's attention? see Osweiler making the final dive at Taylor's ankles, directing it in. Osweiler in the pocket and in traffic just delivers, and it's batted away from
this point again.
Almost intercepted by two Broncos.
Watch right in the middle of the field there. Reads the quarterback's eyes and almost gets over there.
Now it goes about 240, a little bit under the 6 feet that he's listed as. Third and 10. Pressured again. They got him with the blitz. Sack back near midfield by Shea McClellan.
Got in and got the pressure. You can see some hesitation. McClellan's been consistent all year. That's his seventh sack on the year. Out of state job.
Well, second long, steps up, takes a shot near sidelines, and it's caught there by Burrows. Had to come back for it. He said really handled earlier this season. Miller shakes free. And the Sun Devil territory before he's knocked down. Hedrick kind of a wishbone, a little option, and it is a reverse. The take it is Burrows. Burrows gets around the corner, tiptoes down. Second and goal. This little toss here to Harper, who cuts back and scores standing up before 15-yard personal foul, but
it's all
the senior
part of it,
from Texas gets in there.
It's all
true. He's got no next job lined up. Ball on the ground, scooped up, and it's a third non-offensive touchdown for the Broncos. This one from Travis Stanaway.
This is running the football. Crawford fights back to get to the football. He's involved, but there's 25, Hunter White, who's been a player that's been active today. He's on special teams, but he gets he knocks that football loose, and pretty easy, pretty good bounce that time.
Well, he has it again. Still running hard.
I've been driving that bus for about 3 years.
Martin's still running hard, bouncing sideways. Motion, they get the jumbo formation, and they hand it off to Martin, who hammers into the end zone. There is the missing piece, the kickoff return to start it, the touchdown run to finish it.
He's done a lot of work tonight. The least they could do is let him finish off one of the drives.
They're going out in style, too.
How much fun would it have seen Boise State in a BCS bowl game this year?
Well,
not only are they deserving, but how nice would it have been to see Kellen Moore and this group again in a high-profile game, and showing that they can compete with the big boys.
Well, I know that you felt on Bowl Selection Sunday that they were to give one final salute to Moore and this group of seniors.